Casual research and college-level research often start from the same place: curiosity or the desire to solve a problem. Here's an example of a casual problem. I'm hungry and I want to find a barbecue restaurant in my city. To find the right restaurant, I'll identify some preferences, like the ability to order for takeout or style of barbecue. I'll include these preferences as search terms when I'm looking for restaurants using Google. After a few searches, I'll decide on a place to eat. To turn this casual topic into a college-level one, I'll need to spend some time thinking through how the topic might connect to other things I already know and what I'd like to learn about the topic. Mind mapping, also called concept mapping, is a strategy that scholars use to generate ideas for researchable topics and questions. A mind map is an organized chart of what you know about a topic. By making our ideas visible through mind mapping, it's easier to make connections and see patterns in our knowledge. To start mapping, I'll think of as many concepts and terms as possible that are connected to my general topic of barbecue in the Midwest. It helps to take a few minutes to free write or list your ideas as they come to mind. Next, take the list of concepts and terms and organize them thematically. For my topic, I'll group ideas related to the names of people and organizations associated with this topic. I'll add terms like meat industry, African Americans, and restaurant owners. Next, I'll group key concepts. These are usually themes or theories discussed in class that apply to your topic. For my topic, I'll group terms like culinary traditions, gender, and sustainability. Finally, I'll group any terms related to places, time periods, or events connected to my topic. I'll add terms like kitchens, the Great Migration, and Milwaukee. I've chosen these thematic groupings because people in groups, places and events, and key concepts are all different ways I can get specific about my topic. After mapping out my ideas, I'll look for concepts that are interrelated and specific. I'll keep drawing connections between ideas until I found a subtopic that has connections across all the mind mapping categories. These well-defined areas of my mind map can help me develop a topic or research questions focused enough for college-level research and writing. In this example, mind mapping helped me move from the broad topic, barbecue in the Midwest, to the specific research questions, how have African Americans influenced contemporary barbecue cuisine, and what social and political conditions led to the establishment of barbecue restaurants in Milwaukee. Making my ideas visible through mind mapping helped me focus my personal curiosity into a college-level research topic.